Congratulations, your success rate is 100%. 70 out of 70 fields has been entered in so many milliseconds. So guys, I have created a workflow where it's going to enter the data. So let me run it and show you. And then I'm going to teach you how to build this dynamic bot which can enter data into dynamic fields of a web page. So you can see the bot has opened it, clicked on start button. And now it's entering the first name, last name, company name, analyst, phone number, right, email address, and submitting it. So it's going to complete 10 rounds. You can see the bot is active now and is doing its job. Okay, round 3 is running. Let's see. So you can see how nicely it is entering all the data to the right fields. It's entering the first name, then last name, then company name, then role in company, address, email, phone number. So this is the same sequence it is maintaining throughout. Now we are in round 5. Okay, so this is a dynamic way. You can see the fields are changing. The first name is appearing sometimes on the top, sometimes in the middle. Every time the field is changing, right? So it is acting in a very dynamic way. So you can see the first name has gone to the right top corner. So like that, every round the field is changing. This is the RPA challenge. So let's see if my bot is able to score maximum in this RPA challenge. All right, round 8, this is round 9. Let's see that. Okay, phone number, round number 10, the last round. Let's see how much my bot is going to score. Wonderful. You can see my bot has scored 100%, 70 out of 70 fields in less than such a less milliseconds this time. Okay, so guys, try this out and let me know how much you are scoring. Okay, so I'm going to teach you how to design this entire bot from the beginning, and this is such an interesting thing that you are going to face during your job interviews, during your job work once you are selected, right? All of this kind of challenges would come where you have to act on a dynamic web page where the fields are changing or the fields might change. So let's get started, guys. Myself Rakesh from UiPath Expo Hub. As always, I request you, please subscribe to our channel if you are a new visitor. We have lots and tons of videos that you can learn like this. And with that, let's get started, and please do hit on the like button. At the end, do not forget to hit on the like button on our videos. So let's get started. So the very first thing, let me delete this. Okay. Now let me take, instead of sequence, most of my projects are on sequence. So let me go with the flow chart. So that you can do any way. You can use a sequence or a flow chart, doesn't matter. Okay. So flow chart gives a little bit of high level understanding of how the data is flowing, what is going to happen, right? So that way it is easy. Sequence is quite, you know, clumsy to read. So in this one, so the very first thing I have to do, let me show you, there is a website called rpachallenge.com. Okay, so this is the website you need to visit, and this Excel file which I was working from, where the data is, you know, getting in. So this is the first name, last name, company name. So this data is also available here on the site. You can see download Excel. Hit on the download Excel and you will be able to find the data. Okay, so once you are ready with both of these resources, let's get started. The first thing that you want to do is, I wanted to read this Excel file, right? So people who are having problem with Excel application scope, or sometimes they may not have a Excel MS Office package, or they have a advanced version, or they have a very old version, they have challenge in UiPath. For them, you have to use something called workbook. So you have heard that, right? So if you have Excel problems, I would recommend you to go with the workbook. Even it will do the same job as Excel. Okay, so go with the workbook activities. So here I am going with a read range activity to start with. Okay, so once you do this, what you do, right click, and you have an option to set a start node. That means you want to connect it, set a start node. Okay, that means you can see it got connected over here. All right, now after this, what I'm going to do, Just a moment, something went wrong. Let me try it again. Read range, you can drag and drop it here. Either you can, instead of doing a start node, you can also drag and drop like this, whatever way you like. Okay, so click on read range. Here you have to select the file. So here my file I have downloaded here and kept it in the documents. So I'm going to point out to the file. All right, and now this file I want to read the entire range. So if I have to read the entire range, by default you have this, remove this. Okay, and here put a double quote. Done, it's going to read. Now once it reads, I want to store that into a data table. So for that, Control plus K and simply write DT1 or whatever name you want to give, data table 1 I have given, or depending your choice you can give a name. Okay, so once I have it, you will see with the flowchart, once I created data table 1, it is applicable to your entire flowchart. Okay, not like sequence where you have to, sometimes you have to change it, right? So here it is applicable to the entire flowchart. So once I have the data read, the next thing I want to do is I want to open the browser and open that website. For that, use the activity called open browser, drag and drop it. Okay, and then again connect it. So connecting is quite simple, just keep your mouse on the top one and try to drag it. Now in the open browser, I want to open the rpachallenge.com. The best thing, you go to that site, copy this, come back and simply within double quotes paste it. Okay, so my general preference is to use Google Chrome. If you do not have, or if you want to go with IE, you can go with that. Chrome requires the extension that you have to install it. Okay, so the extensions are available here. If you click on home and click on tools, okay, you will have this Chrome extension. You can install it over here or just Google it out, you'll find it out. UiPath Google extension. Okay, so once I have that set, the next thing I want is, once you open it for the very first time, right, so right now you can see the first thing it has to do is it has to click on start button, and then it has to enter the data and then hit on submit. So first is start button. For that, simple thing I have to do is hit on click. Okay, take the click activity, click on indicate element inside the browser, click on this, highlight the start. Okay, just wait for a second. Now you can see the start is highlighted, and here on the top you see that preview, right? You'll see that preview on the right hand side bottom corner, it's showing me now. So once everything's proper, click on it. So that way it is going to hit on the start button. All right, now let's go back to the main window. So this is done. So now it is going to read the data, open the browser. Okay, once it opens the browser, next thing is I have to go through all this data row by row, and you know, start entering the data. So this data, second day, like that, it should read and enter the data. So to read a data table row by row, the activity that we supposed to use is for each row. So drag and drop the for each row. Done, and I am going to make it simple. Okay, there are people where they have used and made it very complicated for you to understand. I am going to make it very simple and very easy, and very easy tactics that I'm going to teach you. So once you are in the for each row, double click on this, and in the for each row, all you have to do, you know, your data table is DT1 that you have created in the beginning. So once you have the DT1, right here, I have to start writing the code where it has to enter the data. Okay, now the only problem with this is dynamic. So every time I hit on submit, you can see the places are changing. The last name is on the top and the entire form is changing. If I hit on submit again, right, you can see again things has changed. If I hit on submit again, so things are keep on changing, right? So you can see again it has completely changed. So it is a dynamic form. For that, you have to use an activity called anchor base. So anchor base is going to help you to select the dynamic things that is happening on a web page and allow you to type in the right place, right? So as a human, I understand where is the first name, and I can see, okay, here I have to enter. Next time I know I have to enter it somewhere else. Okay, here I have to enter. If I hit on submit again, I know I have to here enter. So I know as a human being, as a robot, for it to understand, you have to use the anchor base. There are multiple ways to do it, and anchor base is one of my selection, which I love to do it. So once I use anchor base, the next activity that I have to use, there are two things. One is the anchor, the other one is the activity. So what is the meaning of this? So for example, first time if I select this as anchor, that means this is the anchor. You have seen the ship in the shipyard, right? They will put the anchor. That means it stays there. The ship would stay there. Similar way, anchor here, when I put anchor over here, that means it has to type just below that, right? Something. So it is putting a indication where you have to type the data, around what you have to type the data. So once the anchor is put in the shipyard, the ship stays around the anchor, right? It doesn't go until unless you take out the anchor. The similar way it is going to act. So for this, for the anchor to work, I have to use something called find element. So what is this activity? Drag and drop, click on indicate on screen. And here the first thing I want to enter is first name. So if I hit on this, what would happen? It is going to put the anchor on the first name. And on the right hand side, there is something you have to type the data, right? For that I will be using type into activity. Very simple. So it has put the anchor on the first name and indicate on screen. Click on this. And here I'm going to highlight the first name below that. Okay. So it's going to put the anchor and type the data below that. Okay. So now the anchor base. If you highlight the anchor base, not this activities inside the anchor base, but when you highlight the anchor base, on the right hand side, you have the option anchor position, auto, left, top. I mean, is your anchor is on the top or your anchor is on the left side. So you don't have to select anything because it is changing every time. It is dynamic in our case. So I'll be keeping it as auto. So it will automatically detect where the anchor is. Okay. So that is the flexibility that you have with this activity in UiPath. Very good. So once you have this, anything changes in the RPA challenge website, this is going to find out pretty easily, and I am going to demonstrate that. You have seen it already in the starting of the video, but again, I am still going to create and demonstrate that. Okay. So once you have this done, the next thing is it has to type it. Okay. Where, what it has to type. So remember, you are inside a for each row, right? So it is going through and looping through the data. So here, very simple, you have to do in double quotes. Not in double quotes, simply write row in bracket, write 0.toString. Now the question will arise, why am I writing 0.toString, right? So let me tell you. So what happens when it is in the first loop, loop number one, right? When I say row 0.toString and you type, you will find the first name data there. That means when I say this is the 0, 1, 2, this is how the index naming is being done. So when it is reading this data, right, when I say row 0 means from the first row, it is going to read this one, this data. So this is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. So like that is going to read. So John, then it is going to read Jane, like that is going to read each time the loop is in progress. Okay. This might be slightly confusing for you if you are a newcomer. But again, let me show you or demonstrate you before I continue. So what happens? It will enter the data. Once it enters the data, let's say it's going to do the similar job for first name, last name and everything. And I'm going to do that. After it does what it's supposed to do in the website, it should hit on the submit button. So here, let me pause for a moment just to demonstrate how it works. And I'm going to use a click activity. Okay. And here I have not completed everything now, but again, just to understand how this row works, because this is very important. If you are a newcomer, you will get confused why, how it is working, right? That is why I am going to demonstrate. So I am hitting on submit. So once I do this, what is going to do in this for each row? I am just entering the data for the first name. Okay. Only for the first name, I am entering the data, and I am pointing that the first name you will always find in the column 0. So row 0 means it is nothing but when the loop would run, loop is going to run like this, right? So when the loop runs like this continuously until the end, all the data, it is first name is going to find in the 0 index, the last name is going to find in the 1 index, like that. Okay, that is the meaning. So let me just run it for a second and then you will understand. Then we will compile all the other activities, and I'm going to talk on selectors. So please stay continue with me and learn how the selectors do work. So let me run this and show you. Okay, so what is happening when you are using a read range activity? Ensure if you have opened the Excel file on your PC, just close that and try to rerun it. Okay, if you are using a workbook activity, if you are using an Excel application scope and the activity, then you don't have to close the workbook. So let me hit on run. So you can see the first thing it should do is open the RPA challenge website. Okay, and then the next thing I said, it should hit on start, did. Then it's entering the first name, submit. Okay, it is going to do it for all the names that is there in the Excel file. Do you see? It is just entering the first name because I have written code only for the first name. You are understanding? It is running through the entire Excel file. And in the column 0 or the column A, it is going to read the entire line one by one and is entering the data. Okay, so our percentage is now 14% because we have entered only the first name. So let's continue and do the same job. Okay, so now let me go back. Click on the for each row. In the for each row, what I have done this time, I am just entering the first name. Okay, the same activity I have to repeat for all of them. So what are those datas I have just shown you? First is the first name, the second data is last name, third data is company name, role in company, address, email and phone number. Correct? Okay, let's get started. Very simple. Let's do it very quickly. So what is the easy way if you have to do this repeatedly? So the very simple thing is you right click and copy, or control C, copy it and start pasting the data. So I'm going to start pasting the data. Okay, so now I've pasted it. Now this time all you do, hit on this and click on indicate on screen. Okay, so here once you are, if you are on the Excel file or some other file, you have to go back to the RPA challenge website. All you do is hit on F2. Okay, and go and try to open the RPA challenge website if it is not open. Okay, so now let me again do it, indicate on screen. And here what the next data I want to enter is the last name, right? So I'm putting my anchor on the last name. Again, the same way I need to repeat. And here my last name is in column number 1. So I have to mention row in the bracket. Which column? You have to say column 1 where you have the last name. Okay, so it's going to repeat this and do the same job. Okay, one thing I want to show you. What is that? So what is happening here? When I'm saying find element, on the right hand side you have something called target. Okay, so the target, when you click and look for selector and click on this. Okay, so in the RPA challenge website, what is happening? It is selecting a AA name called first name, tag is level. Okay, now what is AA name? Do you know what is AA name? AA name stands for active accessibility. Okay, this is an attribute. This is the web page attribute called active accessibility name. Okay, AA name is active accessibility name. So the AA name is first name. Now the second one, if I choose last name, I have selected last name. Again, highlight this and go to the selector on the right hand side for that activity. Here the active accessibility name is equals to last name. So that means in the web page it's going to see which is the AA name which contains last name. That is where it will select that as an anchor and type the data below that. Okay, so same thing I'm going to repeat, understanding? But again, when you see the type into activity and look at this selector, what is happening here? It's simply written web control tag input. And here also, if I click on indicate on screen and under the last name, hit on F2, go to your screen, and under the last name, if I just highlight this, right, if you see and try to read the selector, again the selector, everything is same. Okay, so this is not changing. What is changing? This one is changing. So depending on the anchor below that, whatever the text box is there, it's going to enter there. Okay, so very simple. So let me continue to copy paste and keep on selecting the data. Now last name is done. What is your next field? Is company name. Very simple. Click on this one, indicate on screen, and hit on F2 to switch back. And here company name, right? So I'm selecting company name. Done. Now company name is in row number 0, 1, 2. So all I have to do, change it to 2 now. Okay, column number 2. Done. Now the next one, again copy paste. So let me copy paste. And once I do this, again indicate on screen. And what is the next data? Role in company. Hit on F2 and switch back. Role in company, right? So I'm selecting role in company. Done. And then here I have to select row number, column number 3. Okay, done. Very good. Now same thing, you need to again copy paste. Okay, be very, very careful while indicating on the screen. So hit on the find element, hit on indicate on screen. Now what is my next data? I forgot. For next data is role in comparison. Next data is address, right? So address, hit on select the address. Very good. So once the address is done, now address is in column number 4. So simply mention here 4. Done. Very simple. And then again copy paste. Okay, now here my next data is email and then the phone number. So hit on this, indicate on screen, and hit on F2, go back to your site. And here the next is email. So I'm selecting email. Okay, done. Now email is in 0 1 2 3 4 5. Okay, so 5, or else you can always refer the top one. You have written 4, so write 5 here, whatever way you want. Okay, 5, done. Now we are done. The last one we have is, again I am doing a control V, pasting it. And here the last one I have to select is phone number. Indicate on screen and hit on F2, go back to the RPA challenge, and I am going to select the phone number. Done. And here it is, the data is there in the column number 6. Done. So everything is done. Now my RPA challenge is complete. Okay, so let me save this. Just ensure you just go through it. The first name, the second one is last name, then company name, then role in company, then comes the address, then comes the email, then comes the phone number. So it is in the same sequence, right? Very good. So everything is same. So let me just close this. Okay, and go back to the main sequence. So our sequence is ready. Let me save it and try to start it. So let me close the browser so it can start everything from the beginning. Okay, so let's get started and experiment how much we are scoring this time. Okay, let's see that. Hope you would have learned a lot now and you are more confident to work on a dynamic web page. So John, last name Smith, company name IT Solutions. Very good. Address, email address, phone number, and hitting on submit. Okay, so it is doing the entire job. So please do not skip this kind of videos when you are learning. Ensure you start watching everything from the beginning to the end once, and then start your working on your UI path and start designing it. Okay, do not skip the videos. While you skip the video, there are few pointers I might have covered you, and those things you might miss. Few notes I generally make in every video. So please do continue to listen to the entire video. Okay, if you are very confident you know how to test, then it's fine. But again, if you are a beginner, you are going through all this, then please continue to watch the entire video, guys. Okay, so you can see it is entering. We are in round number 6. Now it's 7. Let's see how much. And let me know, okay, how much your bot scored. Did you score 100%? Please comment. I'll be happy to see that it helped you. If you have scored 100% or whatever percentage you have scored, just let me know in the comment section. Okay, you can see it is entering all the data. Very nice. Wow. Okay, so round 10 is, okay, this is the last round. Role in company, programmer. Okay, so you can see it has scored 100% this time. Thank you very much, guys, for continuing with me. Do not forget to hit on the like button. All the videos that you're watching on our channel, and if you think the channel is helping you, please do share with your friends. We want more and more people to get benefited. Please do share with your friend, and it'll also help us for our effort that we are putting in. Thank you guys for watching. We'll get connected again. Thank you. Have a wonderful day.